was the gate. I can't wait to find out what's behind it.
Spoilers, it's Satan. Hey guys, it's ShadeGrey, and welcome back to Darksiders. I'm just watching this living gate walk away because it is epic. So I will epically walk up the stairs just as slowly as it does, and yeah, fuck this. Beat down the door, and let's get moving. This is another great area to grind once you have one of the other weapons in the game. I'll be showing that off later. I'm not picking up that chest just yet. As I mentioned, chests do not refill in this game, so you are kind of stuck with what you get. Another giant flame baby. I haven't mentioned it yet, but Blade Geyser is actually a good way to knock your enemies back and just kind of, good way to deal with more annoying ones that explode. Yes, there's more than one of these things. But what you want to do if you're not surrounded by other enemies is you want to take your time and not let that happen. Every time you see a soul chest, you just want to kind of walk up and punch it in the face, because these chests have faces for some reason. Come here. Ah, that's better. Okay, so. We could go up, but I don't want to do that just yet, I don't think. What we want to do instead is go down here. Hold on. I have something to check. Oh, right. There are four slots in the pause menu as well. Weapons, sub-weapons, and enchantments. And collectibles and something else that I can't think of off the top of my head. In this one, there is a back menu, there is local, there is world, something else again that I can't remember, and there is a guide just in case you forget how to use a move, and of course there's another giant flame baby. Now, whereas the Earthcaller is not a great offensive weapon at the beginning of the game, it's actually a decent way to stall opponents. This is actually how you want to beat the first boss, but I will go into that more in the next video. The giant flame babies here are fairly annoying, and they don't really have a good tell for which attack they're going to do. One just tends to have a little bit more charge-up time than the other, so you just want to keep an eye out for exactly what position their body is going to be. The Earthcaller is, again, a good way to stop them, and the only really ranged weapon you have at the moment, so take advantage of that when you can, and make sure that the giant flame babies don't explode on you. Anyway, before we move on with the rest of the level, we're going to go get a collectible. Ward can actually swim right off the bat, and he can dive. B lowers Ward, A raises him up, and, as with all of War's movements, you can speed up by holding down the defensive button, or right bumper, depending on how you want to translate that. Here, we have a health upgrade. Essentially, what this game amounts to is a piece of heart for those Legend of Zelda fans. Once you collect all four pieces of a skull, another health bar comes around, and you can take more damage. There are a lot of these in the game. I'm not actually sure how many there are, but I do collect a good majority of them. I think I only miss about five. I don't miss that many. I don't know the exact number, so don't quote me on that, guys. But yes, at the moment, all we're doing is smashing Wicked, because smashing Wicked is awesome! Love kicking down doors. Much more satisfying than you would think. And yes, For those of you who are not in the know, War has actually been held prisoner by the Charred Council for about 100 years. This is technically 100 years into the apocalypse, thus why the Earth looks so deteriorated, and it pretty much looks like hell's taken over. Because it has. And one more. This is really easy to rack up combos in this game if you know what you're doing. Oh my god, guys. Stop it! I am trying to do a let's play, and I don't need your shit right now. Okay, this is me just going around exploring a little bit, trying to gain a few more souls. There's actually a Volgrum shop here that I did not know about until this playthrough. I'll be picking that up a little bit later. But, yes, for those of you playing along, this is a good time to get this place on your map. Picking up cars, always a good idea. And I think that's as far this way as I want to go for now. We'll be exploring more that way a little later. But we have a, mini-boss to go fight. So, let's go get our asses kicked, shall we? Oh, wait, forgot. There's a thing over here we need before we go. Well, not need, per se. But, a soul chest is a soul chest. Booyah! Alright, now let's go fight the mini-boss. This guy is kind of a mixed bag, and I'll explain that more after his cutscene. So, I will see you guys in just a minute.
Drumheim Ghoul Stragador! Non Straga Sundara! Do you know what's imprisoned here? There are things even you should fear, horsemen. Once you were strong, but now you are weak and you are alone. The Destroyer knows of your coming. Even now, he moves his legions against you.
Then I'll make this quick.
Alright, welcome to the mini-boss of the Shallow Gallows. I believe that's what it's called. I could be wrong. Scaling Gallows? Whatever. Now, what I meant by mixed bag is he's kind of unique, but enemies tend to show up that look and act just like him a little bit later in the game, and again, I'll be getting to those when we get to them. He's got a couple of attacks, but it's, I'll touch on those when we get to them. As you saw, he's got that axe slamming attack, and he tends to like to summon his minions. He does taunt you a little bit during the fight, but that's not anything that War can do. Oh, enough with the minions. Did you not just see me slaughter the last three? What do you think adding one more is going to do? It's gonna piss me off. See, look, I just chopped that guy in half. No, three, four faces, his legs and his legs and his torso. Ah, and I just did it to the other two too, so bring it! I'll be going into a more effective way to fight this guy a little bit later, but as I said, and this fight, I kind of suck. But, what you see me doing right now, I'm going to be doing a lot more later, so bear that in mind. But if you want a more challenging run, I would suggest doing this. Using the Earth Caller in order to stun lock this guy. Now that spinning attack that he has does deal quite a lot of damage, and it does fly. So I would try and time it so that way you dodge out of the way instead of getting hit like I am. And what's actually going on here, I'm going to admit, is I completely forget that I don't have one of the attacks that I had at the beginning of the game. You have to buy that back. But we'll be touching more on that a little later, because now I'm dead. I'll see you guys in the next video. Hopefully I'll do a lot better at this boss. Don't worry, I don't suck for too long.